Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Celebrity Legacy. Recently, we've received some heartbreaking news about the passing of extraordinary talents. Today's episode is dedicated to honoring their memories. Additionally, we'll recap the stars we've recently lost. Before we start, we kindly ask for your support. If this video or the legacies of these remarkable individuals have touched your life, please consider giving this video a thumbs up as a sign of respect and remembrance. So let's start.
Sandra Reyes was a celebrated Colombian actress known for her versatility and compelling performances in television and film. Born on May 31, 1975, in Bogota, Colombia, Reyes developed an early passion for acting, studying at the National School of Dramatic Arts. She rose to prominence in the late 1990s with her role in the popular telenovela Corazón Prohibido. However, it was her portrayal of Paula Dávila in Pedro el Escamoso, 2001-2003, that catapulted her to international fame. Her nuanced performance earned her accolades and made the show a cultural phenomenon. Reyes also starred in several films, including El Rey, 2004, demonstrating her ability to transition seamlessly between television and cinema. Beyond acting, Reyes was a vocal advocate for environmental conservation and indigenous rights in Colombia. She often used her platform to raise awareness about social and ecological issues. Sandra Reyes passed away from breast cancer on December 1, 2024, at the age of 49. Marshall Brickman was a renowned American screenwriter, director, and musician, celebrated for his sharp wit and contributions to cinema and theater. Born on August 25, 1939, in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, and raised in New York City, Brickman studied at the University of Wisconsin-Madison before embarking on a career in the arts. He gained recognition as a writer for The Tonight Show, starring Johnny Carson, and as a member of The Terriers, a folk music group. However, his collaboration with Woody Allen on films like Annie Hall, 1977, and Manhattan, 1979, cemented his legacy. Brickman won an Academy Award for Best Original Screenplay for Annie Hall, showcasing his talent for blending humor with poignant storytelling. Brickman also directed films such as Simon, 1980, and Lovesick, 1983, and co-wrote the Tony Award-winning musical Jersey Boys, 2005, which celebrated the music of Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Marshall Brickman passed away on November 29, 2024, at the age of 85. His work remains a cornerstone of American film and theater, influencing generations of storytellers. Wayne Northrup was an acclaimed American actor best known for his work in daytime television, particularly in soap operas. Born on April 12, 1947, in Sumner, Washington, Northrup studied at the University of Washington before pursuing a career in acting. He rose to fame with his portrayal of Roman Brady on Days of Our Lives, a role he played from 1981 to 1984, and reprised intermittently over the years, leaving a lasting impact on fans. His brooding charm and dynamic performance made Roman one of the most beloved characters in soap opera history. Northrup also appeared on Dynasty as Michael Culhane and featured in other series, including Fantasy Island and Murder, She Wrote. In addition to his acting, Northrup had a passion for ranching and lived a quieter life with his wife, actress Lynn Herring, whom he married in 1981. Wayne Northrup passed away complications from Alzheimer's disease on November 29, 2024, at the age of 77. His contributions to television and his enduring performances remain cherished by fans and colleagues alike. Scott L. Schwartz was a versatile American film and television actor best known for his imposing presence and roles as larger-than-life characters. Born on March 16, 1959, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Schwartz originally pursued wrestling and stunt work before transitioning to acting. Standing at 6'8", with a commanding build, Schwartz often portrayed villains and enforcers in Hollywood. He gained fame for his role as Bruiser in Ocean's 11, 2001, and its sequels, where his intimidating yet comedic demeanor left a lasting impression. Schwartz also appeared in films like Spider-Man, 2002, and Starsky and Hutch, 2004, and made guest appearances on television shows, including Angel and CSI. Beyond acting, Schwartz was known for his philanthropic work, particularly his dedication to children's hospitals, where he would visit young patients dressed as his movie characters to lift their spirits. Scott L. Schwartz passed away after a long illness on November 26, 2024, at the age of 65. He is remembered for his unforgettable on-screen roles and his generosity off-screen. Chuck Woolery was a prominent American game show host, actor, and musician, celebrated for his charm and wit that entertained audiences for decades. Born on March 16, 1941, in Ashland, Kentucky, Woolery began his career as a musician, performing with the pop group The Avant-Garde, which had a hit with Naturally Stoned in 1968. Woolery transitioned to television, becoming a household name as the original host of Wheel of Fortune, 1975-1981. He later solidified his reputation as a charismatic game show host with popular programs like Love Connection, Scrabble, and Lingo, 2002-2007. Known for his signature line, "We'll be back in 2 and 2," Woolery became a cultural icon. Beyond hosting, Woolery dabbled in acting, appearing in films such as Evil in the Deep, 1976, and guest roles on TV shows. In his later years, he became a political commentator and podcast host, engaging with audiences in new ways. Chuck Woolery passed away on November 23, 2024, at the age of 83. His legacy as a pioneer of game show television remains unparalleled. Niels Aristrup was a distinguished French actor, screenwriter, and director, celebrated for his intense performances and versatility. Born in Paris to a Danish father and a French mother, he embarked on his acting career in the 1970s. Aristrup gained widespread acclaim for his roles in films like The Beat That My Heart Skipped, 2005, and A Prophet, 2009, earning 3 César Awards for Best Supporting Actor. His on-screen presence, marked by depth and gravitas, made him a favorite in French cinema. Aristrup also appeared in international films such as War Horse, 2011, and contributed to the industry as a director and playwright. His command of complex characters extended beyond cinema to television and theater. Niels Aristrup passed away following a long illness on 1 December 2024, at the age of 75. His death was attributed to natural causes, leaving a legacy of nuanced performances and artistic dedication. Aristrup remains an icon of French and European cinema, inspiring actors worldwide. Toni Price was a gifted American country blues singer known for her soulful voice and distinctive fusion of blues, country, and folk. Born on March 13, 1961, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Price developed an early love for music, drawing inspiration from artists like Patsy Cline and Billie Holiday. She began her career performing in Nashville, but later moved to Austin, Texas, where her music flourished. Price became a staple of the Austin music scene, especially known for her long-running hippie hour performances at the Continental Club. Her debut album, Swim Away, 1993, received critical acclaim and established her as a force in the Americana genre. Over the years, she released several albums, including Hey, 1995, and Low Down and Up, 1999, showcasing her emotive storytelling and unique style. Price earned multiple Austin Music Awards and a devoted fan base for her passionate live performances. Toni Price passed away from complications of a brain aneurysm on November 20, 2024, at the age of 63. Her music continues to resonate with fans, reflecting her heartfelt artistry and enduring legacy. Rico Carty was a Dominican professional baseball player renowned for his batting prowess and resilience throughout his career. Born on September 1, 1939, in San Pedro de Macorís, Dominican Republic, Cardi initially pursued boxing before turning to baseball, where he became a natural talent. Cardi debuted in Major League Baseball, MLB, with the Milwaukee Braves in 1963 and quickly established himself as one of the league's top hitters. Nicknamed the Big Boy, he won the National League batting title in 1970 with an impressive .366 average, earning him a place in the All-Star game the same year. His career, spanning from 1963 to 1979, included stints with teams like the Atlanta Braves, Texas Rangers, and Toronto Blue Jays. Despite battling injuries and a bout with tuberculosis, Cardi's determination and hitting consistency made him a fan favorite. He retired with a .299 career batting average and 204 home runs. Rico Cardi passed away in Atlanta, Georgia on November 23, 2024, at the age of 85. His legacy as one of the finest hitters from the Dominican Republic endures in baseball history. Tony Todd was a celebrated American actor known for his commanding presence and iconic roles in horror and dramatic films. Born on December 4, 1954 in Washington, D.C., Todd studied at the University of Connecticut and trained at the Eugene O'Neill Theater Center. His theatrical background laid the foundation for his powerful on-screen performances. Todd gained international fame for his chilling portrayal of the titular character in the Candyman film series, 1992-2021. His deep, resonant voice and intense screen presence made him a horror legend. He also appeared in other memorable films, such as The Rock, 1996, Final Destination series, and Night of the Living Dead, 1990. In addition to his film career, Todd had numerous television roles, including appearances on Star Trek, The Next Generation, The Flash, and 24. His dedication to the craft also extended to voice acting, where his distinct voice lent gravitas to animated series and video games. Tony Todd passed away at the age of 69. His legacy as a versatile actor and horror icon remains unmatched. Quincy Jones was an iconic American record producer, composer, and musician whose influence shaped modern music across genres. Born on March 14, 1933, in Chicago, Illinois, Jones began his career as a jazz trumpeter, working with legends like Lionel Hampton and Dizzy Gillespie. He transitioned into composing and arranging, scoring for films like The Pawnbroker, 1964, and In the Heat of the Night, 1967. Jones became one of the most celebrated producers in music history, collaborating with Michael Jackson on groundbreaking albums such as Off the Wall, 1979, Thriller, 1982, and Bad, 1987. His work on Thriller earned him global acclaim, helping it become the best-selling album of all time. Jones also produced hits for artists like Frank Sinatra, Aretha Franklin, and Ray Charles. A 28-time Grammy Award winner, Jones broke barriers in television as the first African-American music director for major network programs. Quincy Jones passed away at the age of 91. His visionary contributions to music, film, and culture remain an enduring legacy. Today, breaking news. Rumors about William Shatner's death surfaced recently, spreading quickly on social media. However, these reports were entirely false, as Shatner remains alive and active at 93. As often happens with prominent figures, the rumors were fueled by unverified sources and viral posts. Shatner himself, known for his sense of humor, has addressed similar rumors in the past with witty remarks, turning them into lighthearted interactions with his fans. Born on March 22, 1931, in Montreal, Canada, William Shatner rose to fame as Captain James T. Kirk on Star Trek, 1966-1969, a role that became legendary in science fiction. Shatner's portrayal of the intrepid starship captain earned him a loyal fan base and redefined the genre on television. Over the years, he reprised the role in numerous Star Trek films, solidifying his place in pop culture. Beyond Star Trek, Shatner explored diverse roles, starring in series like T.J. Hooker in the 1980s and later in Boston Legal as Denny Crane, which won him Emmy and Golden Globe Awards. Shatner's career has spanned acting, directing, writing, and music. His eclectic pursuits include writing Star Trek novels, recording spoken word albums, and even venturing into reality television with shows like The Unexplained. In 2021, Shatner made history by going to space aboard Blue Origin's New Shepard, becoming the oldest person to travel into space, a fitting achievement for a lifelong star traveler. Shatner continues to be a remarkable presence in entertainment, admired for his energy, humor, and iconic contributions.